Does the newest Ryzen 3000 BIOS update for the ASRock B450M Pro 4 MicroATX mainboard lock overclocking for the AMD Athlon 200GE AM4 processor? One of my viewers, VP, found out that the newest BIOS version 3.30 does lock overclocking for Athlon processors. When he wasn't able to reflash his mainboard to version 3.10, and asked for my help, I told him he was so out of luck. According to the note on the BIOS page for the Ryzen 3000 BIOS updates, user will not be able to flash previous BIOS once upgrading to this BIOS version. He came back a while later with a workaround for reflashing the mainboard. Watch this video for a brief history on the Athlon processors, my thoughts on flashing the mainboard, and how to reflash the mainboard to regain lost features from the Ryzen 3000 BIOS updates. My name is CD Reimer and welcome to my channel. Please comment, like, and subscribe, and click on the notification bell to see more videos like this. If you only want to learn how to reflash the mainboard, jump to this timestamp in the video. When the AMD Athlon 200GE came out in August 2018, overclocking processor was not an option. You could change the multiplier and voltage settings in the BIOS, but those settings wouldn't stick after the mainboard rebooted. That disappointed many users who wanted an inexpensive Ryzen processor that they could overclock like crazy. Late last year, MSI released a BIOS update for their mainboards that unlock overclocking for the 200GE up to 3.9 GHz. When it became obvious that users would buy a MSI mainboard just to overclock the 200GE, other mainboard manufacturers released BIOS updates with this unofficial feature. The 200GE became a very popular processor, especially when on sale for $50. And why did ASRock remove overclocking of the 200GE from the recent Ryzen 3000 BIOS updates? It's just not ASRock that is doing this. All the mainboard manufacturers are releasing Ryzen 3000 BIOS updates that remove support for older APUs and hard drive RAID, and even replacing a fancy interface with a basic interface for changing the settings. The ROM chip on most 300 and 400 series mainboards are not big enough for the added support of the new Ryzen 3000 processors that came out last week. For AMD to keep their promise of backward compatibility with the newest Ryzen processors and the oldest mainboards, something old had to go away for something new. For users who got a brand new mainboard, updating to the latest BIOS version is usually recommended. With the Ryzen 3000 processor support being shoehorned into BIOS updates, you need to be very careful about updating your BIOS to avoid losing features that you may still need. As a rule of thumb, you shouldn't update your BIOS unless the update fixes a problem or added features that you need. What one BIOS update can give, another BIOS update can take away. When I got the ASRock B450M Pro 4 mainboard 4 months ago, the installed BIOS was version 1.60. I initially flashed the mainboard to version 2.00 that came out on December 24th, 2019, which allowed the Athlon 200GE to overclock from 3.2 GHz to 3.9 GHz with a slight voltage adjustment. When I planned out my replacement system at the beginning of 2019, I settled on the Athlon 200GE, 2-core class 4 threads, AM4 processor, to replace my older X-8300 8-core AM3 processor. The two processors have near identical benchmarks, despite having different architectures and core counts. Being able to overclock the 200GE with an added performance bonus to make up for the zest that comes from missing extra cores. If you want to buy any of the components that I selected for my own system, the part list with affiliate links are in the description below. Version 3.10 came out on March 15, 2019 to add support for the new Athlon 220GE and 240 GE processors. Those new Athlons are slightly faster, more expensive, and not worth the money when you can get the 200 GE on sale for $50 and overclock up to 3.9 GHz. Note that this is the first BIOS update with the warning, user will not be able to flash previous BIOS once upgrading to this BIOS version. Something to keep in mind when reflashing the mainboard. One new feature for 3.10 was an auto setting for the processor voltage. The best out-of-box overclocking for the 200 GE is setting the multiplier to 3800 and the voltage to auto. I could fiddle around with the voltage to overclock the 200 GE to 3.9 GHz, 4.0 GHz, or 4.1 GHz. Windows 10 works fine at 3.9 GHz, but stops loading if overclocked 4.0 GHz or higher. Tweaking the voltage for an extra 100 MHz at 3.9 GHz wasn't worth the trouble when I can set it to auto and forget about it. With 3.8 GHz across all four threads and auto voltage at the default 1.3 volt on the 200 GE, my system has been rock stable for months. The newest BIOS updates are version 3.30 that came out on May 21st, 2019. And version 3.40 that came out on July 5th, 2019 to add support for the new Ryzen 3000 processors. If you watch all the YouTube videos about the Ryzen 3000 launch, the new processors weren't reaching the rated boost frequency, speed, and throwing off some benchmarks. Most reviewers had a week to test the new processors prior to the launch date on Sunday, July 7th, 2019. Those who tested the processor on the first BIOS update had some funky benchmarks. Those who tested the processor with the second BIOS update had better benchmarks. AMD also launched their new 5700 and 5700XT video cards in the same week. Most reviewers were ready to drop dead from making multiple videos for the two launches. The Ryzen 3000 BIOS updates remove overclocking for the Athlon 200 GE on the Antirock B450M Pro 4 mainboard. I'm not sure what else was removed since Atrox release notes on their BIOS updates are minimal at best. Not that the new BIOS updates matter to me. Unless I'm replacing the 200 GE with a Ryzen 3000 processor in the near future, I don't need to flash my mainboard to the latest and greatest Ryzen 3000 BIOS updates. VP built a new system with the same processor, mainboard, and memory that I selected for my own system. VP made the mistake of flashing the mainboard to the newest BIOS update, version 3.30, without realizing what that meant for the Athlon 200 GE. No matter what numbers he put in for the multiplier and voltage settings, the 200 GE would not overclock and reverted to 3.2 GHz after the mainboard rebooted. Reflashing the mainboard to version 3.10 did not work, as expected from the BIOS update release notes. That didn't stop VP from finding an earlier version to reflash the mainboard with. Here are the simplified steps for reflashing the ASRock B450M Pro 4 Micro ATX mainboard back to version 3.10 for overclocking the Athlon 200 GE. Warning, whenever you update the BIOS, you risk the possibility of bricking your mainboard if something goes wrong. First, reflash the mainboard to BIOS version 1.60. Second, reflash the mainboard to BIOS version 2.00. Third, reflash the mainboard to BIOS version 3.15. Keep in mind that I haven't personally tried this on my own mainboard. Based on the long comment thread that VP and I had on my first Ryzen video, reflashing to an earlier version of the BIOS should work as described. I want to thank VP for the very interesting comment thread and providing a workaround that made this video possible. Make sure that you are subscribed to my channel as I will have future videos about the Athlon 200 GE. Links to third-party websites mentioned in this video can be found in a related article on my website at www.cdrymer.com. Thank you for watching.